I'm gonna get it recorded before it gets broke. Hi! Good evening, everybody! Welcome to your Jubilant Saturday, June the 18th, 2022 evening video. Because there's no turning point tonight. So, this is your only other video for today. And if you might not know, it is kind of lightening up because it is after 6 in the morning when I'm recording this up on Saturday. So, and sorry for being in the inside video yesterday. I just got I got real late, and before I could get outside, it was already lightening up. I like to have the darkness behind me so there's not no much distraction. I could just have it focused on me and I don't have to worry about. Plus, it's a lot quieter at night with the nighttime. You still have some noisy vehicles going by here, but today we're going to be talking about episode 740 or 754, part 2, and we're going to be discussing how are you from a new name author, Tom Felton, F-E-L-T-E-N, Felton. And it's derived from Luke 23:32-43. So if you're excited about this one, smash the like button. Comment, how are you? How are you in your life right now? Are you going through a trial, tribulation, or whatever? If you are, I'll pray for you about it. But speaking of praying, birthdays, anniversaries, and other prayer requests in the comment section below. And what did you do for your Saturday activities? What was something you did today? Was it planned or unplanned? Right. Subscribe if you're new, turn on notifications, share the video and channel with your family and friends, and help me reach a reasonable subscriber amount by episode 800, which is now 46 days away. And help me reach the goal of 100 subscribers by the end of the calendar summer. You know how it changes from summer to fall in September? You have until then to get me to 100. And I will be greatly, greatly appreciative of that if you can do that for me. Or if you'll help spread my channel out so other people can see it and start subscribing. Which right now I'm at 10 subscribers, so I got 90 more to go to get to 100. So you got 90 to go in those 3 months. Let's get a subscriber a day for 90 days. I guess is what you call it. So in 90 days, I would like to be at 100. But I would like to be at a reasonable amount after the 1st of August when we hit 800 episodes on the Daily Devo videos. So. But how are you? From Tom Felton, F-E-L-T-E-N. He says, Carla, C-H-A-R-L-A, that's how it's spelled. Carla, however it's pronounced, was dying, and she knew it. While she was lying on her hospital room bed, her surgeon and a group of young interns poured into the room. And for the next several minutes, the doctor ignored Charla, as he described her terminal condition to the interns. Finally, he turned to her and asked, "And how are you?" Carla weakly smiled and warmly told the group about her hope and peace in Jesus. So some 2,000 years ago, Jesus' battered, naked body hung in humiliation on a cross before a crowd of onlookers. Hold on just a second. I gotta get me a swallow of my drink real quick. Sorry. My camera angle's gonna change just for a second. Sorry about that. Sorry about that. My throat was getting dry and I couldn't hardly get a word edgewise. So sorry about that. But some 2,000 years ago, Jesus' battered, naked body hung on in humiliation on a cross before a crowd of onlookers. Would he lash out at his tormentors? No. Jesus said, "Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing." Luke 23:34. Though falsely convicted and crucified, he prayed for his enemies. Later, he told another humiliated man, a criminal, that because of the man's faith, he would soon be with him in paradise. Verse 43. You remember, he goes, "Today thou shalt be with me in paradise." And I can remember the Easter program, where we do the crucifixion scene, and the person playing Jesus was out there, "Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do." That's the line on that part. But every time I hear that, I can hear that person, whoever, I'm not saying who played him, but who was up there. It was pretty fun. So, in his pain and shame, Jesus chose to share words of hope and life out of love for others. So it's Carla, or however it's pronounced. Charla concluded sharing Christ to her listeners. She posed the question back to the doctor. She tenderly looked into his tearful eyes and asked, "And how are you?" So by God's grace and power, she shared words of life, showing love and concern for him and others in the room. So in whatever trying situation we may face today, or in the days ahead, let's trust God to provide courage to lovingly speak words of life. So what difficult and humbling circumstances are you facing these days? And how can you rest on Jesus during this challenging season? So, remember, proverbial answers and ideas in the comment section on those questions, if you feel free to, in the comments. Just make sure you put Q1 or Q2 for which one you're leaving a response about. But ponder those questions by saying this phrase. It should be on the bottom of the screen, so make sure your subtitles are on so you can see them. Sorry about that. There. But say, yeah, it's starting to lighten up behind me or outside. So what? Says Jesus, "I pray you for your example of grace and humility. Please help me reflect these qualities in my words." So your Bible reading today is Nehemiah chapters 10 and 11, and in Acts 4, the first part of Acts 4, 1 through 27. So, tomorrow in your beautiful, your glorious Lord's Day Sunday, June the 19th, 2022, episode 755, part 2, we're going to be talking about In your daily bread, being fatherless no more, from Win Collier, derived from Psalm 68, 1 through 10. And we just read Psalm 68 yesterday in the Turning Point, for the Turning Point daily thing. So, wait a minute. No. No, we didn't. We read 68 on Thursday. So, But stay tuned for that. I'll get to that later tonight, but you'll see that one tomorrow. And you're coming up tomorrow in your turning point. I'm just going to go ahead and reiterate. We are going to be looking at the front half of the New Testament with the book of Matthew in the bookends number 3. So we're looking at the front half of the New Testament. Your Bible reading for this weekend is Psalm 73 through 80. So 3, 4, 5, and 6. 73, 4, 5, and 6. You read those today if you're reading them. And then you read the other 4 tomorrow to spread it out for the weekend. So, but I'll be getting to that sometime later tonight. So you'll see that tomorrow. So, but speaking of tomorrow we will be in number 91 of the Dove series with the Prodigal Father, episode 7, 55, part 1, which will be your morning, your 8 o'clock episode, or your 8 o'clock video. And then your part 2 video will be at 1:45 tomorrow. And we'll be talking about being fatherless no more. From Wynn Collier, derived from Psalm 68, 1-10. So, and the morning video, we're beginning with Luke 15, 22 and 23. And it's from Henry M. Morris. So, and then we have the front end of the New Testament with the book of Matthew in our bookends weekend series number 3. So stay tuned. I'll get all 3 of those later tonight. Hopefully by midnight. Around midnight, 1 o'clock, something like that. And then you'll see those tomorrow. So, with that said, I love you. I appreciate you. Sorry for this one being a little longer than the morning video was. But I love you. I appreciate you. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Keep on keeping on and trusting God, and He'll keep you safe and all you say and do in 2022. And until tomorrow, peace out, everybody. So long. Come back tomorrow for those 3 great lessons from God. And I'll see everybody then. So see y'all tomorrow. Have a great rest of your Jubilant Saturday and rest of your evening. And come back tomorrow for another glorious Lord's Day Sunday. And I'll see everybody tomorrow. So God bless. And goodbye.